Hello, Nicole here, and today I've decided to talk about Australian carbon pollution. Okay, so here's the gist. Our carbon pollution may appear a small proportion of the global total, but actually it puts us amongst the world's top polluters. You know what? That deserves facepalm. Yes. Although we only produce less than 1.5% of global emissions, we place among the 20 highest emitting countries. That's not good! Facepalm. The country's annual pollution is roughly about the same as countries like Spain, France, Italy, South Korea, and the US. Come on, people, really, we're as bad as America. And they have the biggest economy. And Australia's population is tiny compared to all those other countries. Facepalm. But seriously, Australia's emissions are really just less than 2% of the global total. But with other countries also making about roughly the same, that would make up over 40% of the global emissions. I have a video of my good friend, Professor Will Steffen, explaining the risks of exceeding a 2-degree limit and impacts of climate change.
The major impacts of climate change are those that are directly related to temperature. And there are two of them that we can point to straight away. One is heat waves, and a good example of that is the heat wave we saw in Melbourne in 2009. Now, many people may not realize, but more people died from the heat wave than they did from the bushfire. The temperature in Melbourne hit 46.3 degrees Celsius, and that was not just a new record, it massively broke the previous record by about 3 degrees. That sort of change does not occur without an underlying change in the temperature. The second type of risk that we face that's directly related to temperature is that of bushfires. And again, we've seen the big fires around Canberra in 2003, the Black Saturday fires in Victoria in 2009. On a longer term basis, and perhaps more subtle, is the rise in sea level. We're a coastal country. Much of our population lives around the coastline. Much of our infrastructure is situated on the coastline. And this is vulnerable as the century progresses and sea level rises. The question that we face now, the immediate question over the next decade, is how far will we allow temperature to increase? That'll determine the world in which our children and grandchildren have to live. So the question we need to focus on is, are we headed for a 2-degree world or are we headed for a 4-degree world? Most of the world's countries, including Australia, have signed on as a matter of policy that we don't want to see the temperature rise more than 2 degrees above pre-industrial. The science says our challenge is clear. We need to get emissions moving downwards this decade, which means we need to make policy decisions, we need to make technological changes, we need to make behavioral changes this decade and keep moving towards decarbonization if we want to meet that policy objective that we've already set.
Well, folks, I hope you enjoyed this partially educational and extremely corny video of mine. Till next time. Facepalm. That's so lame. Our global pollution. Okay, well, here's the gist. Okay, here's the gist. Our carbon pollution may appear a small proportion of the global total, but actually, it puts us amongst the world's top polluters. You know what? That deserves facepalm. My eyebrows look really good in this one.